Today we are going to discuss about cam profile in which knife edge follower with uniform velocity as well as offset distance. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So let's take one example. Draw the profile of a cam operating a knife edge follower. Follower lives through 40 mm, that is the stroke length, 60 degree of rotation, that is angle of ascent. The follower remains at rest for the next 30 degree of rotation of cam. That means it is a dwell period. The follower then descend to its original position during 60 degree of rotation. That means this is the angle of descent. The follower remains at rest for the rest of revolution. So this is remaining dwell period. The least radius of the cam is 50 mm. Sometimes it is known as base radius. The motion during ascent and descent is uniform velocity, very important data. The axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of the camshaft. Very important data, offset distance is given to you as 20 mm. So up to here, this is a problem for the diploma student. Now point number 8 is particularly used for the degree engineering student. Determine maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower during its ascent and descent if the cam rotates at 200 rpm. So first we will discuss about the cam profile and then we will solve the numerical portion. So this is the point given to you in the description. So summarize over here. So let's start with the displacement diagram first. So draw the horizontal line. Then it is given to you as stroke length 40 mm. So draw the vertical line as 40 mm. And then draw the horizontal line. First outstroke 60 degree. So take the scale as 1 cm is equal to 10 degree. So that this outstroke length is 6 cm. Then next dwell is 30 degree. So 3 cm is the length for the dwell, then return stroke is 60 degree. So it is the 6 cm for the return stroke. And remaining dwell, that is 210 degree, you can't accommodate 21 cm in your sketchbook. So you can use this symbol. Now divide this outstroke angle into the 6 equal division and give the name as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Draw the vertical line passing through all these points. Similarly, you can do for the return stroke, divide it into the 6 equal division, draw the vertical line passing through these all points from 0 dash to 6 dash. Then it is given to you as uniform velocity for both outstroke and return stroke. So draw the straight inclined line for the outstroke, for the dwell it should be the horizontal line, and for the return stroke it should be the straight inclined line, remaining dwell horizontal line. So this dark line that represent as uniform velocity for both outstroke as well as return stroke. So in the examination this line must be the dark line. Then give the name intersection as A, B, C, D, E, F. For the return stroke it should be the G, H, I, J, K, L. So this is your displacement diagram. Now start with the cam profile. So randomly take one point, give the name as O. Now here the offset distance is given to you as 20 mm. So draw the circle with radius as 20 mm and that is known as the offset circle. And then draw the axis line such that it must be the tangent to this offset circle. And then minimum cam radius is given to you as 50 mm. So draw this circle as 50 mm radius, that is known as the base circle, and draw the symbol for the knife edge follower. Take care over here, the offset distance is given to you as 20 mm. So your axis line must be 20 mm from this vertical line. If offset distance is not given to you, then your axis line must be passing through this O point. Now join 0 to O, so that is your line from where you can start the outstroke, next dwell, return stroke and remaining dwell. Here you have to assume that the cam rotated in the clockwise direction because of it is not given to you, and so that your angle must be in the anti-clockwise direction with reference to this line. So first 60 degree, then 30 degree and then 60 degree. Now divide this outstroke angle into the 6 equal division and give the name as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, you can do for the return stroke. Divide this total angle into the 6 equal division with the help of the protractor and give the name as 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash and 6 dash. Now take care over here, offset distance is given to you. So you have to draw the tangent line. So see how I can draw the tangent line. Tangent line must be passing through the 1, as well as tangent to this offset circle. Similarly, this line must be tangent to this offset circle as well as passing through the 2 point. So you have to set the scale such that each and every time this red line must be tangent to this circle. Similarly, for the return stroke, this all red line must be tangent to this offset circle and passing through this 0, 1, 2, up to 6. Now take compass, set the radius as 1A, draw the, so you will get the A point. Similarly, 2B is the radius, so that you will locate the B point. C3 is the radius, draw the arc so that you will locate the C point. 4D is the radius, so that you will locate the D point. Then 5E is the radius, draw the arc so you will get the E point. 6F is the radius, draw the arc so you will get the F. Similarly, you can follow for the 0-G, then 1-H, then 2-I, then 3-J, then 4-K, and at last 5-L. So over here, observe that this is the knife edge follower. So draw the smooth curve passing through these all points. Directly you will get the cam profile starting from 0 to 6. With the help of the compass you can do it, and then draw the smooth curve passing through all these points. So this is the first task up to the cam profile. Now we'll see the second part as a numerical portion. So point number A, determine maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower during its ascent and descent if the cam rotates at 200 rpm. So for the uniform velocity, V is equal to omega s upon theta. So you can note down over here, maximum velocity omega s upon theta. Now for the maximum velocity, you have to find the omega. So 2 pi n upon 60, you know that formula. N is given to you 200 rpm. So you will get omega 20.94 radian per second. Now for the ascent, maximum velocity is omega s upon theta A for the ascent. So theta A is the ascent angle. That is given to you 60 degree. Convert it into the radian. So how you can convert it? Multiply 60 with pi by 180. So you will get this value, and so that you will get 800 mm per second maximum velocity for ascent. Similarly, for the descent, it is omega s upon theta d instead of theta a, because of for the descent. So this is the descent angle. So you will get descent angle into the radian 1.047, because it is given to you for the descent 60 degree. So in this problem, theta and theta d both are the same. So we will get directly the value maximum velocity for ascent and descent are same. So don't waste the time for the examination if theta and theta d both are same. Now for the maximum acceleration. So you know that for the uniform velocity, maximum acceleration is 0. So I can directly write maximum acceleration for the ascent as well as descent is 0 meter per second square. So thank you my dear friends. So I hope you can understand how you can draw the cam profile as well as how you can solve the numerical portion.